Hi, my name is Javier Ramirez. I'm one of the founders of Tiawaki. And Tiawaki is a collaboration tool for software developers where you can share interesting links, best practices, documentation, mistakes, gossip with other developers. And I'm going to tell you today how we are using and how you can use Google BigQuery to run analytics over anything which is interesting for your business. In our case, analytics is allowing us to have insights on how users are using the tool in a very economical way and without having to worry about keeping our own servers, upgrading, maintaining them, or how much data we are storing, or if it's going to be cost efficient when we grow up. So once you are in the console, what you are going to see is a quite familiar interface if you know SQL. Since we are already developers, for us SQL was really easy. For example, here I'm getting from the date, I'm getting first the year and then the month, and then they are going to be counting how many users are being deleted from the tool. So SQL is quite convenient for us. This query is quite basic, but I've heard about people, for example, in Khan Academy, that they are learning, the business people, they are learning SQL for running their own reports. So they don't have to depend on the development team, which is quite interesting, especially because, you know, if you have to run like many reports, you don't want to have like dependencies from anyone. So yeah, when you run the query, you can see the results straightforward. And here's one of the metrics that are important for us, just how many users are abandoning the tool. But we can do something more interesting. Like, for example, I told you before, in Tiawaki, we want to know how users are interacting with each other. So in this particular query, what we are going to see is per every different month and every different team, how many items they are posting, how many items they are sharing between the team members, which is something that could be difficult to get with other tools. But here it's just a query. And as you can see, we have already like some teams starting in November during the beta period that were posting like, I don't know, over 100 items. And that's quite interesting because you can see which teams are more valuable for you, which team are less valuable. Then of course you can see as new people are entering into the platform, they start with no contents at all. But you know, in the next months, it's the number is increasing. So to us, it's helping us to get some insights of how people are using Tiawaki. But what other things you can do apart from getting aggregates from how teams are using the tool? The other important metric for us is which users individually are the most valuable, who are using the tool the most. And with this simple query, I'm getting just the internal ID of the user which is using the system the most, which accidentally in this case, it's me because I'm one of the founders and I've been using the tool before it was in public. But yeah, this just give me a number. It's not really useful, but it would be much better if I could have a way of seeing the individual navigation of the user, how they are actually using the tool, our application. So in this other query, what I'm getting is, give me the date and the URL from our database where the user, it's the 26, which is in this case, it's me. And you know, the challenge here is on the results, I can see the URL is all the time the same. And that's because in our system, we have a notification part which every few seconds is going to request if we have new contents from the server. So if I want to get information, that's really not useful. And I can see in this new version of the query, I'm telling, okay, give me all the results except the one about the notifications count. And here I can see already information. I can see that the part I've been using the most lately, it's like the South interface, categories for one particular team, some different best practices. And this is really cool because I can see if users are using the tool in one way or another. For example, we are seeing that some parts of the tool are not being used that much. And we actually should either redesign them or even stop working on them. Because if we are working on different parts of the tool, but the users are not actually using those things, we are wasting the time and the money. So this is just an example of what you can do. Depending on your business, you will have like different metrics that are more important for you. But once you have the queries designed, you don't want to come here all the time and be writing the queries, executing the queries, because you know it's wasting time and it's not the best way to do it. So the next thing I'm going to show you is how you can automate this interface with BigQuery, so you can have your reports sent to you periodically. And in order to work with BigQuery, you can use different things. If you are a developer, probably you want to use the API, but you can use something called Google App Scripts, which is a smaller version of JavaScript. If you know JavaScript, then you already know how to use App Scripts, and you can interact with virtually any API from Google, like for example, Google Analytics or Google BigQuery in this case, Gmail, Google Docs. Let's see what I'm doing here. I'm creating a new folder on my Google Docs. And in this new folder, I'm going to create a new spreadsheet with the date of today. And I'm going to call a function to populate the data from my new users. Then I'm going to create a new sheet in the spreadsheet. I'm going to add the delete users, insert a new sheet for the unique users, populate the data, and just send the email. And after I execute this script, I'm getting an email directly into my Gmail inbox, which is the summary of how many users I have new in this month, how many users have removed from the tool, and how many unique users we are seeing, and the link to the spreadsheet in which you can see directly all the results, like you know the report here for the three metrics that we are checking every day. And this is just a spreadsheet, so you can do like any graph you want, anything you want to do, it's up to you. But let's see the detail of how I'm getting this data into the spreadsheet. The easiest part is just sending the email. So if you go to the mailer tab, you're going to see sending an email is as easy as adding the recipient of the email, copy anyone you want, add the subject, as the body of the email as an HTML, and that's about it. And before this function, what I'm getting is the reference for the link to the spreadsheet, which is the spreadsheet that you can see later in the email, as I can show you here. So yeah, we're inserting the link directly. So the most difficult part in this script is creating the data for the spreadsheet, but that's also quite easy. The first part is we have three metrics. I have three functions here. One is getting the new users per month, which is a query quite similar to the one I saw you before in the console. Then I have another one, which is for the delete users per month. And I have one for the unique users. And once you have that, the only thing you have to do is just launching the query, which is a matter of calling BigQuery and getting the reference for the job ID. And then we are going just to be waiting until BigQuery get the results for us. So we are sleeping every half a second until we get the results. And once we have the results, we are just going to populate those results into the different cells of the spreadsheet in using a very simple JavaScript. So that's about it. Once you have that, you are ready to get your data into your spreadsheet. And yeah, that's how it looks, as I saw you before. But the last part we need to do is you don't want to run this manually. You want to schedule, so periodically you are getting these reports to your mailbox. If you go to the triggers in App Script, you can see in our case, we have a date timer. So every morning between 9 and 10, we are getting the mail into the inbox. But if you have other requirements, you can, for example, set time-driven every hour or even every minute. And as an example, this year on Google I/O, I met one person and he's using App Scripts, BigQuery, and Google Docs to have a live dashboard. And every 30 seconds, he's refreshing the queries and you can see in real time how the graphics are changing. So depending what you want to do, you can have like different options. But the interesting part for us, it's really easy to set up. OK, so that's how we are using BigQuery. And in case you are wondering why we then use something like Google Analytics, it's because we are getting data from different places, not just from the website, but also from our API. And in analytics, getting data from other sources is kind of tricky. The other thing is we are interested not only in the individual users, how they are clicking around links or anything. We wanted to keep track of how they are collaborating in different teams, what we are sharing with each other. So we needed like a more powerful solution, still keeping a fraction of the cost. And to us, it's working because we have at the moment like 10 million rows. We are running the daily reports that you just saw, and we are paying like $1 a month.